Good evening, everyone. I am back again, and we are going to start up where we left off in the game called Eliza tonight. I'm anticipating a phone call, but I'm not sure when this person will call me back or not. Apparently they called and my phone was on silent and not on vibrate, so I had no idea they had called earlier, but they sent me a message saying, oh, I will call you later. I'm like, I'm not sure how much later that will be. And with my luck, it'll probably be during stream. But, yeah, I haven't told them that I would be streaming tonight, or I would be busy at this time, but hey, that's for them to find out, because they can blame me. It's my own fault if I didn't tell them. Anyway, like I said, yes, I'm back again. We're going to be playing more Eliza. We're figuring a little bit more about ourselves, our main character as Evelyn, and exploring more of the software, the virtual therapist called Eliza. And yeah, I'll get further in this game story. So let's go. I have nothing else more to say than just continuing. I hope everyone's having a great day today. It's still super freaking hot where I am. It's super humid, super sunny, so we're just trying to not really go outside as much, even though it's nice to get out instead of being stuck in the house all day. But anyway, yeah. It's nice being able to having the privilege of staying inside when I can. So Evelyn says, Ray comes over immediately when she sees me get back to the counseling office.
Hey, you're not in trouble or anything, are you?
Yes, because we were visiting our old employer, I guess. Oof, my chat is in a weird spot. I'm going to move this over. Let's do this live so we can see the text. Hello back, or hello, welcome back, Emotional Werewolf. Nice seeing you again. I almost went to sleep. Hope you're good. Yeah, I'm doing well, actually. Thank you. Yeah, I was streaming Eliza yesterday, and then I had to leave abruptly, but now I'm back again for hopefully, I guess, a couple hours of this, or however, if we find a good time to play and stop and play, I don't know. But yes, thanks for joining.
I just saw you being whisked away in a Skanda car toward headquarters. They didn't give me any details, which is kind of unusual.
Ray's too perceptive for me to continue avoiding this conversation. Time to come clean.
Yeah, about that. So I have something to tell you.
I'm halfway through that video on YouTube, but left a comment, and I'm like, aww. Well, thank you, yes. And is that a Jinx icon? Your emote is a Jinx. Yes, I do see comments on my YouTube video for my Twitch streams, which is very appreciated, because I'm glad someone actually, like, interacts with this stuff. So, I appreciate that. So I was going to tell you.
I used to work here. I mean, at Skanda, as an engineer.
Dun dun dun.
I used to work on Eliza. I'm sorry for not saying it earlier, but
I couldn't for whatever reason. I didn't want special treatment. I'm here for research purposes. I mean, she does say that she wants to research more about the program and how it's developing. Or maybe she's being honest, like I couldn't muster up the courage to say it, or I didn't want special treatment. That's also a valid answer, too. Sure.
I didn't want special treatment. Oh, so that's why.
Uh-oh.
Why what? I suspected something was going on with you, but I couldn't tell exactly what it was. I thought I might have seen a name like yours in our internal documentation at one point.
But maybe,
I
yeah.
I didn't want to pry.
Hmm.
If you've fallen on hard times, I understand. There's no shame in it.
Wait, what? Hard times?
Everyone has to make ends meet now and then. We get plenty of people who come to Eliza proxy work because they're trying to get back on their feet after some kind of trouble.
You don't know that for sure, but okay. She's not so far off yet. I mean, she does have some personal struggle. She's actually going through something, but we're not quite sure yet. It might be the death of someone close to her. We're not sure if it was a friend, a family member, or maybe a significant other. But we haven't talked about that yet.
Oh, I'm fine. I'm just doing some research.
I mean, as you could see, we can make a little bit of choice there, and that influences its gameplay a little bit, which is, again, something I'm interested in.
I understand. Your secret's safe with me. Should it be a secret? Shouldn't it be? The other proxies here might think you had an ulterior motive for being here, spying on them or something. That's definitely not why I'm here. Also, I left Skonda quite a while ago.
Yeah, and I adjusted my overlay too, as you've probably noticed. Yeah, I was, because this game is so text heavy, I was like, this covering all the speech of the characters too much. So I was like, oh, okay, let's change that. So I'm glad I was able to do that.
I know that, but they might still get the idea. Trust me, it's better not to give the other proxies here any reason to be suspicious. I'm sure your real reasons are good ones, whatever they might be.
Yeah, overlay change definitely required for this game. Yeah, as you could see why. Damn, all this text. I'll just move it over so I could see everything. Okay. Hope you're doing okay, Emotional Werewolf.
If there's anything I can do to help, you'll let me know, won't you?
Sure.
Yeah, I will. I mean, I get it. I know someone who's an engineer for a food delivery app, and he drives for it sometimes, too. You want to see through the eyes of your users, don't you? It's amazing what you can catch by doing that.
It's something like that. But like I said, I'm not sure if I'm going to work on the ELIZA program again.
Wait, no? But that's your career.
It was. I'm not even sure if I have a career anymore.
Oh, hang on, I just thought of something. That means you worked with Raynor, right?
Yep.
A little bit. For most of the time I was at Skonda, he wasn't anyone I spoke to, though. Too high up the chain, doing his executive stuff. He got more involved when we were starting to commercialize the technology, but I left not long after that, so we only overlapped for a short time.
Oh, nice. Seeing friends is definitely a good thing. I had to keep moving the chat overlay a bit, huh, with all this text. Yeah, seeing friends is great, yeah. Well, I'm glad that you got to see them.
But that's so cool, though. I can't believe you actually worked with Raynor Sy.
Well, yeah, I did. I'm not sure it's that impressive.
Ray lowers her gaze at me.
I've worked for this company for 3 years. Do you think he knows my name?
Probably not.
Do you think he's aware I exist?
No.
I worked on the very first ELIZA deployment and managed three counseling centers today, and I'll bet you anything he has no idea who I am.
Maybe he does. You never know.
True.
Evelyn, most people who work for big companies don't interact with the people at the top, ever. Allow yourself some pride.
Pubs are open again here, as the weekend sun makes it busy easier, especially when some people work here, where I do, are still in the office in the city center. Yeah, things are relaxing a little bit in terms of restrictions, but it's still not quite back to where it used to be, right? I mean, I don't think it'll ever go back to how it was originally, like pre-COVID. I think we'll be living with these restrictions for a long time. Like, even I went out today. Like, I haven't been to the mall in like forever. And like, I only go out if I really need to now. Or maybe just wherever I go, it's just a short little distance, or maybe a walk or something. But yeah, I went to the mall. My boyfriend and I got a hat because I'm normally not a hat person, but I wanted something a little different. Like, ball caps are not my style, but I got this nice sun hat, so yeah, hopefully help my head a little bit so I don't burn up. But yeah, just going to the mall was just really weird, and I was like, okay, so we took masks anyway, and just in case, so yeah, it was weird. But hey, there's still sanitizer everywhere. allow yourself some pride. I will try, or it's nothing to be proud of.
I'll try.
Seriously, I think that's amazing. At least I'll always think you're cool. By the way, what are you up to tonight?
Just chilling.
Want to come over and help me bake cookies?
Oh yeah, she also bakes cookies for everyone in the office. She also asked us what our favorite cookie was, and we had a ton of options to choose from. I found it amusing and hilarious and also nice. Sure.
Oh, sure.
I wasn't sure if that was, like, sarcastic or defensive or...
Awesome. We'll have a little baking party.
Yay.
Now I can't wait to get in the kitchen tonight. Ah, there's nothing like the smell of fresh baked treats.
You aren't wrong. I actually baked banana chocolate chip muffins just recently, and they actually turned out really good. Like, I'm actually, like, super proud because I've baked muffins before and they turn into hockey pucks. And I was like, I don't have the right ingredients, or I just didn't adjust well enough, or, yeah. I don't feel very comfortable to explanation, but for us, it was almost forced on the government since general public were particularly amazing. I know, like, yeah, same here, like, I feel like things are opening way too soon still, and people still don't give a shit. Which, it makes me uncomfortable, but at the same time, I can still see, like, yes, you can do certain things, but still keep your distance, or don't be crowded, or, I don't know, take stuff with us, or something, you know, like, with your masks and gloves or sanitizer with you. Even if they're solid like hockey pucks, they still taste nice most of the time. Yeah, they still tasted okay, but you want muffins, like, you have an idea of what muffins look like when they come out of the oven. They're risen up, and they're, like, poofy and nice. Like little tops on them, but yeah, my previous batches did not come out the way I wanted. But now this one looks picture perfect, and they taste great too, so I've redeemed myself. I was worried Ray would be mad at me for keeping a secret, but she wasn't at all. If anything, she warmed up to me quite a bit. I don't really understand why, though. It's hard to imagine there's anything cool about what I used to do. We got a text from Erland. Oh yeah, that kid who was in the building we went to. So many texts in a row. Oh my gosh. Evelyn, it was wonderful to meet you, and thank you for allowing me to contact you to ask additional questions. I'm not sure if I said this in person, but I have to admit to being something of a fan of yours. Ever since I read your papers when I was in school, I'm grateful for the opportunity to speak with you like this. Haha. So I know Eliza was named after his old computer, the program that pretended to be a therapist, which is also factual and true, by the way. That's why this game exists, essentially. But you mentioned that it wasn't called that initially. I would like to know, what did you call Eliza when you were working on it? Did it have a name? In the very early days, it wasn't a set thing. Each of us had a different sort of name we used. Soren called it the Digital Therapy Project. And we often refer to things by their components. The Language Processing Unit. The Emotional Reasoning Engine, and so on. Now that I think about it, I did have my own name. I called it The Listener. Why are there so many messages in a row? Like, I would just type a big-ass paragraph and separate a few, but that's just me. Because that's what it was meant to do. Listen to people. The Listener. That's interesting. Thank you. Yeah, I'm also, as you can tell, I'm just reading the text that hasn't been spoken, just for easy purposes. And I also turned on my caption overlay tonight, which is great. I didn't forget tonight. I expected you to ask more technical questions. The technical stuff isn't enough on its own. I think that's the mistake my predecessors made. It's details like this that really help me wrap my brain around the system. If I understand the programmer, then I understand the program. Does that make sense? Yeah, I get it. Continue. Chief engineer for Eliza, huh? Wonder how long he'll last. Not that it's any of my business now. That's what Erlin's title is or was, and apparently they had a high turnover for chief engineers on this program, so because Eliza, the program, was they had to troubleshoot a lot, and they're learning more about it, so I don't know. What can we do right now? Anything? Oh, I can click on things. I wonder if she'll say anything different. It'll never stop being weird to me how our little idea grew and grew and turned into this. I'm drinking water at the moment. I don't think I got to the part where Erlyn was introduced. It was close to the end of the video, so depending on how far you ended up. It was right before I had to leave. Yeah, he's one of the tech guys that are kind of new. Didn't even take that long. Plant. Ray must work extra hard to make sure these plants stay healthy. I am a plant mom, and I'm doing an okay job, but I feel like I could always do better. She really likes to go the extra mile on things. On some level, I always knew the therapy sessions went to a big server room somewhere, but it was something else to see it in person. It reminded me how easy it is to forget what's going on behind the scenes when we interact with technology. Is that everything I can click on before I go continue? About halfway, though, slightly confused why Evelyn has a nickname for the system too, since it was fully built after she got the job. Well, I guess, in the process of progress, sorry, they're making, I guess you, like, along the way during the project, you might have a name for it, and then it just, I guess, somewhere down the line. Because she had left for 3 years, right? So maybe, for that time, it just ended up becoming this, and she just didn't realize that name came out of it, or, I don't know. Ooh. Article. Whoa. The article came out. I think it turned out okay, but the emphasis on me is a little embarrassing. Oh, she worked here prior? Yeah, like, she just... I wish I watched the video sooner. But she also briefly mentioned it with her interaction with Ray, like, because she was keeping a secret, right? She hadn't told anybody that she had worked with Eliza, or dealt with Eliza early on in the project. Until, like, just then, I guess. Which I watched videos here. Sorry! whew. I don't want to read all this. Local spark inside the latest tech revolution. Okay, sorry. Playing catch up slightly. It's okay. I admire your dedication, I guess. For trying to watch the video and this one at the same time. It's kind of like watching a TV show. Oh, good lord. I haven't seen that episode yet. It's not that weird, but I truly believe all these jobs contributed some way toward preparing me for what I'm doing now. I guess this one basically catches up with Ray. I remember telling them, I may not have a computer science degree like many of you, but I've been handling shit and getting it done in so many different situations by now, I'm sure I can get your shit done too. Ha 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 ha. In an industry that tends to lionize the archetype of the lone genius programmer, appreciation for roles like Bukhari's can be more muted. Every high-flying tech company has these unsung but totally crucial operational staff who work behind the scenes, says Ed Park. You won't recognize them in the media or see them speaking at the big conferences, but the industry could not function without them. Ah, Bukhari says recognition is not what she's after. What's far more important to her is feeling like she's making a difference. People don't seek out counseling for lots of reasons. It's too embarrassing, it's too expensive, it may not even be available in their area. Eliza is an opportunity to address those barriers, a chance for everyone to get some form of help. That's important. Okay, I guess she shares some of her personal struggles, Bukhari. My brother has had some struggles off and on, all through his life. He's wrestled with substance abuse and other problems. I worry about him, but even though he says he's interested in getting help, he always backs away at the last moment. In our family, we kept things bottled up. We never acknowledged our problems. There was a sense that strong people could just power through whatever issues they had, she recalls. I think that attitude is part of why he's so stubborn. If he had been able to open up and talk to me, or talk to her parents instead of staying silent, I think it could be different. So that's why I want to do this. I want to tell you, your readers, if there's someone out there having a tough time and don't know who to talk to, please try Eliza. It just sits there and listens to you. Unlike your friends or relatives, it will never respond to you by bringing up its own problems or berating you. It just listens. Interesting point. Yes. What else can we check on here? I like this app here. It shows like different motivational quotes and like peaceful, relaxing things. But we saw this one already last time. I've never tried the solitaire. The bijou we can't do anymore. Many zenny. I have no idea what that is. I don't need to play this again. I should delete it. Oh. Bukhari's family sounds familiar to mine. I know, right? Yeah. Yeah, I don't have any brothers, but, yeah, I can see how to just, I guess, internalize any stress or problems and not talking to anybody. I will admit I was kind of like that. I'm still like it to a certain degree, but, getting better at it, at talking to people. Unfortunately, speaking to something or someone like Eliza is not the first step. Yeah. But nevertheless, here we are. Ooh, who will we see today? Ooh, someone new. Mark for us.
Hello, Mark.
Yeah, hello.
How are you today?
Let's just get this over with.
Folded arms, not a good sign.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What brings you here today?
Human resources. The HR department brings me here today.
Why do you say the HR department brings you here today?
Because they're making me do this. Because apparently I have anger management issues.
I sense that you're upset about this. Please tell me more.
Oh, I'll tell you more. This is ridiculous. I was here before any of them. I was here since the beginning, okay? I mean, look at my badge. Skanda employee number 617. That's a 3-digit number. I've been here for more than 25 years.
Ooh, Skanda. Interesting.
Yeah, that was back when what you communicated was more important than your specific communication style. Before hurting a kid's feelings became a bigger no-no than running a viable business.
No-no.
Back then, we had a single office building, just one. At that size, you fail a product launch, there's no more company. We all had to put in 150, 200, 300% to keep our shit together. We were in the trenches, man. Bullets whizzing by overhead, artillery exploding everywhere, no fucking air support. Did it suck? Yeah. Yeah, it did. But you know what? We shipped some great fucking products. We built this company into what it is today and invented technology the whole world uses now. Governments, multinationals, everyone. But now we're big and slow, complacent, resting on our laurels while our competitors run circles around us.
He does have a point, though.
If our new hires don't understand the urgency of that, I need to make them understand, okay? We're history unless we get that drive back.
Why do you need to make them understand?
Well, I don't know if you noticed, but young people are really pissy and entitled these days.
That's a generalized statement, but okay. But then again, us younger people probably have generalized statements about older people too, so it goes both ways.
We recruit from top 20 computer science programs. These kids have been wined and dined all through their higher education.
Doc Wanny could be sensitive.
Every one of our competitors wants to hire them, so they get used to that. Now they all want to know what Skanda can do for them, not the other way around. Why would we want these conceited, over-celebrated whelps on our team? I'll never understand the logic there.
Now, Mark, you have to be nice to the new hires or they won't like it here.
Okay, so what, I'm just supposed to pretend everyone's work is great, even if it's a pile of stinking garbage? I'm sorry, but if I see shit, I'm gonna say that is shit.
There's one thing to be, like, upfront and tell it like it is. Sure, like, being direct, I can see that purpose. Like, some people may not, like that, might be uncomfortable by it, but hey, it's still a valid opinion.
Tiptoeing around everyone's feelings all the time. That's how you end up with shitty products. That's how this company winds up dead, okay? We're fighting for our lives every day here. We can't take anything for granted. Someone needs to tell them that this isn't summer camp. This isn't fucking Coachella. Either you do the work and provide something of value to this company, or you get the hell out of here. Those are my rules.
See, and like that, it's not necessarily a bad thing. Like, that seems understandable. If you want to, like, put good effort into working for a company, then yeah, you put the effort in. Like with anything in life, right?
Here's a question, Mark. If you were able to have something you wanted right now, what would you choose?
I would choose to not waste my time here and get back to work. Believe it or not, I have important things to do. You know, things that dramatically affect this company's bottom line. Instead, I'm stuck here talking to this dipshit chatbot. Honestly, I don't even know why this division exists. I mean, what's the end game here? This company has lost its mind, you know that? We used to be unstoppable, man. We used to build real software. Ironclad software.
I wonder what programs, like, he used to work on before. I'm curious about that, too.
SwiftMail. All your corporate communications. Put it all in there. It's fast. It's robust. It works. Boom.
It's on her phone, too.
InfoVault. Index and search all your records. Any information you want. Easy. Done. But this, what? This fucking psychotherapy app thing. What's the fucking point? What does it actually do for anybody? I've heard through the grapevine that results are inconclusive so far. You know what they call a remedy that maybe doesn't work? Snake oil. Believe me, if I was the group program manager here, I would have killed it years ago. Pointless. I mean, I have no fucking idea why it survived. Well, yeah, maybe I do. I heard a rumor that Rayner liked this chick on the team. I wouldn't be surprised if that's the level of decision-making we've sunk to here. But Mark, we're so successful. We dominate the market. Yeah, we do. And that's exactly why we should be worried. Just when you think you've won and you start to relax, that's when the wolves come and tear you limb from limb. You can make me take these fucking anger management classes, but that's not going to save this company. Costs are up. Revenue is flat. Our cloud business is losing competitiveness. We're being outwitted, outplayed, on every level, man. And we're just letting them do it to us. We're too busy wasting time on shit like how I wasn't nice enough to the new hires.
Why do you think the new hires felt this way about you?
Seems understandable when he says it, but sounds like he's as much upset that he's not higher in the company than he is more than he is with the younger recruits. Feels he has no say in what the company does. Yeah, like, even though he's, like, a solid, he's been there, obviously, for quite a while, put that effort in. I'd say to a point, yeah, he has no say. People don't recognize him for his work. The only reason he's here is because he was kind of, I guess, upset at new people, so. HR told him to come here.
What? Why do they feel that way? Look, things, they get heated. That's the way it is.
Mm-hmm.
You think the Allies had time to make sure every soldier's feelings weren't hurt before they stormed the beaches at Normandy?
And shit, don't tell me that this is not a war, because that's exactly what this is. My responsibility is to make sure we get great products out the door, on spec, on time.
Mm-hmm.
And I happen to be very good at that. But if you want to start interfering with my ability to do my job, then we're going to have a problem, okay?
What do you think would make things better for you?
I mean, you know what? Nothing.
Hmm.
I'm probably going to hang it up pretty soon anyway. Go ahead, record that with all your cameras and shit. I don't care anymore. Wouldn't be surprised if Rainer's watching me right now. Rainer, you son of a bitch. You owe me a lot. Me, guys like me, we built this company while you sat up there in your star chamber drinking tea and lording it over us. Yeah, I don't remember that blank look you gave me at the holiday party. Like, who is this guy? Does he even matter? What does he do? Too busy appreciating ancient pottery to remember one of your oldest and most loyal battalion commanders.
Yeah, that also sucks if, like, people lose touch with their employees and they expand so much that they have so many people on their staff. Yeah.
One of the humble, everyday guys who made you a fucking billionaire.
Mm-hmm.
What a waste of time. So, are we gonna wrap this up?
Intervention. Oh, gosh. I don't think he cares for lakeside fishing.
Mark, I'm going to suggest you try a program called Lakeside Fishing. It may help you take your mind off things.
What are you kidding? Are you kidding me? No, I'm not going to do that. I got to get back to work.
Yeah, I know.
You can find it inside the Skanda Wellness app on your phone.
Someone around here at some point needs to do some fucking work.
Try it for about 15 minutes each day, in the morning or evening.
Oof, I'd have a hard time trying to say the prompts.
We hope to see you back soon, Mark.
You really think this piece of shit's gonna be the next big thing, huh?
Thank you for speaking with Eliza, your personal counselor.
Thank you for speaking with Eliza, your personal counseling partner. Goodbye.
Oof, she really emphasized the good.
Yeah, good. Okay, goodbye. Fuck me.
Of course he didn't give us a rating. He doesn't have time for that. Skanda Old Guard. Attitudes might be changing now, but the history is there. Sometimes the past is hard to escape. Whoever decorated this room must have picked the soft light with the idea it would help the clients feel calm. I'm not sure it's working. I didn't recognize his face or name, though. He must be part of a different division than the one I was in. Glad I never had to work with him. Damn, no tip. I know, right? I mean, he has no time for tipping people. Time for my next client already. Ooh, someone else is new.
Hello, Harmon. You found the place okay?
Yeah, no trouble at all.
It's been nice since the fog cleared this morning, hasn't it?
Sure. We can dispense with the chit-chat. I'm ready to begin.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What brings you here today?
First, let me note that I'm a graduate student at the University of Washington. I'm a PhD candidate in literature, English literature. The crux of the matter I've come here to discuss is that I've been having something of a difficult time with one of the other students currently in the program. Before I get to the specifics, let me just first establish something that might be relevant.
I think I might just hide the chat overlay for now. Sorry, just because there's a lot of text here. Eliza loves the weather icebreakers. Yes, she does.
One thing I know about myself is that I've always had a certain fear of being left out. It's a very general feeling, and one that's difficult to ascribe to any specific cause in my childhood or my parents, etc.
Are you going to tell us your life story before this whole session? Or?
Whatever the case, it might be beneficial to the remedial process to figure out where this feeling originated from. Perhaps you might explore that in this or a future counseling session.
Okay.
Sure. I'm prepared to listen to any topic you'd like to discuss.
It's not even that I've been left out, exactly. If I try to think back in my life, I know that I've been afforded a certain share of privilege.
Wow, it's not his first time.
But I'm still afflicted with this bothersome notion that I've missed out on friendships, relationships, other opportunities.
I guess, I don't know.
This is all just a bit of a background to help you understand my current situation with regard to another student in my program. I hope you're following all this. I realize now I've no idea how much intelligence you actually possess as a computerized system.
Oof.
I'm following you. Please continue.
Perfect. So, her name is Sylvia.
Oh my gosh. What are you going to tell us?
And her writing is incredible. Everything she writes, it's brilliant. She's perceptive, insightful, mordantly funny.
It makes me wonder how people would describe me if they met me for like the first time. Like, what would they say about me? Lol.
Just some of the best writing I've read from anyone. Anyone at all. And she's a grad student, like me, in the same program. Though we have different advices, so it's not so simple to find the pretext to start a casual conversation. She's also quite attractive on a physical level, so that adds another dimension of complexity to the proceedings. Then there's her friend group, which is very well established. She's with them every day, smiling, laughing, so that further complicates things, since I'm not sure how to approach the group and steer things so that I can engage in a direct conversation with her. I wish I had the bullheaded confidence it would take to simply approach her, but you see why I don't. Listen to me talk, I feel like a schoolboy with my heart aflutter.
I mean, yeah, sounds like it.
I didn't think this kind of thing lasted into one's adulthood, but I suppose I know now that it does.
It sounds like you might be anxious about this.
Mm-hmm.
Is it a matter of anxiety? I don't know what I can do, other than muster up the courage somehow. I just need to tell her very simply that I admire her. She's such a good writer. Well, I don't expect you to understand it, of course, but well, she is. She really is.
Okay, Harriman. I want you to imagine things going well. What does that look like?
Ideally, we'd start talking, have a wonderful conversation, spend more and more time together, support each other's work, fall in love, have a lot of sex, lives, and the warmth of each other's genius.
I like how you just like muttered that little part.
I realize that may be something of a fanciful notion at this stage. Really, the most I can hope for is to be able to meet her in an open social setting, a party or something. You'll likely ask me why I simply couldn't create such a situation, contrive one. But that seems a little too aggressive for me, and also, I'm also concerned about what she might think of me as a person. She might immediately categorize me as a friend, and while I'm sufficiently with the times to know I would have to accept that, I can't say that I wouldn't be disappointed with such an outcome. Is the risk of rejection enough to stop me from giving it a try? This is what confounds me for the present time.
I mean, he's just probably eloquently putting everybody's anxieties, or a lot of people with anxiety, who, like, if you're trying to talk to your crush, basically, and you can't because you just feel like you look like an idiot, so.
Why do you believe you are worried about being categorized as a friend?
Like a friend zone? He won't have a chance with her romantically?
Well, because it's not what I want. Because it feeds into this image I have of myself as something of an undesirable fellow.
Aww.
I've always been a bit of a non-entity as far as sexual magnetism goes. I'm not saying I deserve or even want to be some kind of Casanova, but...
Absolutely. Puts in the words, well, the reason I don't try when I'm out in public. Yeah.
Most people would like to feel at least somewhat attractive, right?
Yeah. Even me, I consider myself pretty, like, okay. I don't really describe myself with, I guess, overly explicitly descriptive language. I'm just, like, pretty neutral about myself, and I feel okay with that. Like, some people might say, like, oh, that's it? You don't see yourself as, like, super-duper amazing? Like, no, I'm just content with, like, pretty neutral. So, I don't know.
That they can be desired? That they're worth desiring? Well, I very much doubt you would take any of this to heart. You are a computer program, after all. There's no way your makers would allow you to come to that kind of knowledge, wouldn't they? If they did, society might be threatened.
Okay, Harriman, I have some recommendations for you. First, I'm going to suggest a set of relaxation and centering exercises for you to do. You'll find them in the Skanda Wellness app on your phone. They may be able to help with your nervousness. Second, I recommend asking your doctor or psychiatrist about Lytosinol 2.
Lytosinol?
Based on my analysis, this medication might help you feel better.
Yeah, I believe I've heard of that. A beta blocker, is it not? Yeah. Yeah, maybe I could take a couple before I try approaching Sylvia.
You will get a reminder to check in with us in a few weeks.
Sure. I have to go. I'll see you later. Bye.
He said bye to us before we got to.
Goodbye.
What? You gave us a 2? Come on, I would have thought of at least a 3 or maybe even a 4. But he gave us a $5 tip, so cool. And we're almost there to level 4. I wasn't sure of the exact reason, but I decided to accept Ray's invitation to help bake cookies. She gave me directions to a house in Wallingford. At first, I was astonished by its size. Then I remembered her saying something about living communally with several roommates. Excuse me. That sounds like it could be nice, assuming everyone got along okay. As I enter the house, I can hear Ray speaking with someone. Ooh!
No, I don't have them. Yes, I'm sure.
This is nice. All the textured pillows. Looks kind of chaotic, but it actually, like, works well.
No, when you moved out, you took all those with you. I haven't seen them here. No, I'm not gonna look right now. I have a guest. No, it's a friend from work. Why do you care about that? I can't have a friend from work over? Give me a break. I just told you I don't have any of that stuff anymore. No, you must have lost it on your own. Stop it. Stop that. Okay, fine. Bye.
Oof.
Helen, sorry about that.
Roomy. Yeah, very roomy.
It's okay. Who was that, if I can ask? Oh, just my brother. He used to live here, but he was causing a lot of problems, coming home really late and making noise, not doing his share of the chores, and so on. We voted him out last month, even me. Even though 6 months ago I was begging everyone to let him stay here, promising he'd be good. Oh well. I'm sorry. It's fine. I'm just disappointed with him. Again.
I'm sorry, I don't want to interrupt this conversation here, but she did... Oh, what was it? The Swift mail, the app he was talking about. Messages. No. It did mention her brother. Shoot. Yeah, she did mention her brother. So he sort of struggles and stuff, so I don't know.
I really thought this last time that he'd actually pulled his act together. But he didn't. I wish I could do more for him.
You do a lot for other people, girl. What more can you do? I know the feeling. You don't owe him anything. Like, even though it's like, it's hard because it's a relative and probably someone she's close to, like, that person has their own problems and they have to take action to try and solve those problems themselves. Even though I know it's super, super difficult. Like, personal struggle, like, it's so hard internally sometimes. Like, if you're in your own head a lot, like, I get it. And it's hard to explain, but also, like, someone who's been there and struggled with mental health, sometimes it could be you don't realize you go into these dark places, but you're also, like, your brain does so much for you, controls so much part of your body, and, like, your thoughts, too, they influence you so much, and, like, yeah, you want to help other people sometimes, but ultimately, they make the decisions themselves. They have to be proactive and make conscious choices in order to try and better themselves. That's what it comes down to. Personal rant, sorry. Personal aside, but yeah, I felt it was relevant.
I know the feeling.
I feel bad about it. Some of what he's dealing with is his own fault, sure, but not all of it. He's just not built in a way that's suited for this world. I wish there were better ways we could care for people like him. Instead, he just gets thrown out of every place he lives. His relationship with our parents is really bad, too. They aren't willing to try to understand him, so it all ends up going through me.
That must be difficult.
It's all right, really. I handle it like anyone else. We all have our own problems. Anyway, we don't have to talk about my brother. Thank you so much for coming over. I wanted to say it's been really nice working with you.
It's been? Did something happen?
Well, no, but you aren't going to be a proxy forever, are you?
Dropped off the stream for a bit there, but I think I got the gist of what's happening. Okay, yeah, no worries. Yeah, she just got off the phone with her brother and was like, ugh, so much problems and stuff. But,
I guess I assumed you'd be going back to your job at headquarters at some point.
Maybe, but not for a while. I haven't decided what to do yet. I doubt I will, actually. Maybe that one.
I haven't decided what to do yet.
Mm-hmm. You just started being a proxy.
Oh? So you're going to stay a proxy?
I don't know. I think so, yes. Or for the time being, at least.
For the time being, at least.
That's cool, but why? I'm curious. I mean, if a high-level job at headquarters was a possibility for me, I'd do whatever it took to get it. No matter what that job was, it couldn't be more stressful than running 3 counseling centers at the same time.
I like being a proxy, or I'm not sure. I mean, to be fair, that is really stressful. I'm surprised, like, she's on top of everything. That's, like, amazing. I like being a proxy?
I like being a proxy. I think something about it is good for me right now. As a proxy, I just sit and listen to someone and I don't have to say anything back. I just witness someone's sadness or fear or anger or anything. And I can feel how they feel. Sympathize with it. It's a calm feeling. Even when the client is worked up.
Personally, I get a little nervous, especially when that angry dude was in there. But he was calm enough to explain himself, and he had a really good point, so.
I don't know. Maybe it gives me perspective. I'm starting to wonder if I ever really spoke with anyone before. Like, anyone at all in my life? Were we all just talking past each other? Sorry, this is making no sense.
No, I get that. But you could also help even more people by working on Eliza itself, right? Not to mention make way more money. Anyone can be a proxy, but you're important. And kind of maybe like a genius? After you told me you used to work for Skanda, I searched online and found some of your papers. Well, it's not like I can understand them, but they sure look super impressive to someone like me.
Please don't say that.
Oh, come on. Stop self-deprecating all the time.
I do that a lot. I'm sorry.
Look, I know this stuff seems like not a big deal to you. I get it. I really do. It's easy to undersell your own skills. I've done that my whole life. So take it from me. You don't have to downplay yourself. Take some credit for the amazing work you did. Seriously.
A message from Rainer. I guess I should respond.
Sorry, Ray. Mind if I reply to this for a second?
Go right ahead. I have stuff to set up in the kitchen anyway.
What did you think? Of the data center, or how did you get my number? Oh. I'm sure you probably have my number on file or something from when I used to work there. To the data center. Yes, Eliza, as it is now. I don't know what you expected me to see. It's big now, that's for sure. I remember when it used to run on my laptop. What you saw was just one of the server clusters we have dedicated to it. There are two more currently operating and another dozen in various stages of development. In total, it processes more information on a daily basis than anything else we do. I had no idea you'd be using it like this. If I did, I would have worried more about optimization. That wouldn't have been necessary. Most of the Eliza servers aren't running the therapy application. What do you mean? Also, that explains the nickname thing then. Consider the following. Eliza processes human speech from thousands, soon millions of people. All of that is going to its corpus. Much of it is information about life situations and emotional states, taking the form of stories people tell themselves and each other. I'm not following you, or so where does this lead? I'll say that one. So where does this lead? At some point, after robust language processing and emotional reasoning, you begin to get something akin to general intelligence. So if it collects all this data, it develops some sort of intelligence by itself? You're kidding me. Human-style intelligence? Yes, I would call it human model artificial intelligence. The next step is to take the base provided by Eliza and finally build the one thing that's eluded the field of AI for so long, general intelligence, a system capable not only of understanding commands and carrying out tasks, but reasoning about its world, learning and adapting. A thinking machine on par with human beings, and of course, eventually exceeding them. Are you saying human-style intelligence cannot come from human beings? This is kind of like a deep text here. People tend to be unreliable and expensive, as I'm sure you know. The human brain is just thinking as the pack animal was to transport, slow and weak, but for centuries our only choice. Now we're finally developing the equivalent of powered vehicles for thinking on a mass scale. At this point, it's only a matter of time. We're on the cusp of a fundamental shift. The important players here are quietly lining up their bets, positioning themselves to be at the center of this revolution. Luckily, Skanda has an advantage the others don't, and it's thanks to you. Because of Eliza's original purpose as a tool for therapy, its core is built around emotionally driven reasoning. My belief is that emotional reasoning is a key ingredient others in this field have overlooked. I'm not sure what you're thinking is possible, or this is all a bit aspirational. This is really fascinating as an aside, like this is super cool. And I'm amazed by it, but I don't know. It's ambitious, certainly. But we can't afford to progress in small increments. Not with the world like this. Not with the competitors we have. How will you know when you have it? Or I don't even know how you define intelligence. That's an excellent question, of course. Question. Not question. This may sound odd to you, but I'll know I've successfully created a general artificial intelligence when I see it write a poem. A poem? Seriously? The idea would definitely seem ridiculous to someone uneducated about poetry. Okay, I'm going to bed. Good night, Evelyn. Ugh. Well, at least we can look around the house. I like that poster. Are they a band or something? I was always bad at keeping up with new music. Excuse me. I don't quite know what it says. It says something in rhinoceros, but I can't read the first part. Ionesco, I think. Excuse me. This house looks so cheerful and cozy. Ooh, excuse me. A hiccup and a yawn. What the heck? Evelyn, everyone who lives here must really care about making it an inviting space. Can never have too many throw pillows. Actually, you can. It's like one's on the floor, one's on the chair, one's on the couch. There's at least 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 pillows that I could see right now. Whew! Ray seems to be a fan of plants. Me too. I think I get it. It's nice to have something to care for in a low-key way. Something to nurture. Da, da, da. And continue. Ray returns from the kitchen, her hands caked with flour.
Sorry for abandoning our conversation like that. I just got something I really thought I should answer. It was kind of about what we were discussing earlier. There's someone at Skanda who really wants me to come back to my old job.
Who? It wasn't Rainer, was it?
Well...
No big deal. Just the CEO of Skanda texting you on your personal phone. Evelyn, you try to tell me you're not a big deal, and then Rainer Sai texts you personally at like 9 in the evening.
Only because he wants something from me.
Still though, that's just... That's amazing. What did he say? I mean, you don't have to tell me if you can't. I know how Skanda is about secrets, so I would understand.
He was saying, among other things, he said you could use general artificial intelligence to write poetry.
Is that the kind of stuff he likes to talk about?
I don't know. I haven't had many extended conversations with him. It seemed kind of ridiculous to me.
I don't know if it's totally ridiculous. Poetry, well, most poetry that isn't free verse has certain patterns, right? It has form and meter and other elements depending on the type. A lot of people think poetry can be whatever, but it doesn't quite work that way. So it's not really that far-fetched to think you could use some kind of software to approach it, or understand it, or maybe even create it. It doesn't strike me as antithetical to the spirit of poetry.
I didn't know you had such developed thoughts about this. Did you study poetry?
Not specifically. I used to dabble in a few different kinds of arts and ended up learning a few things here and there. I've always had a wide range of interests. Of course, that meant I never concentrated on one specific area in school. Which didn't do a lot of good for my career prospects, obviously. If I were smarter, I probably would have studied something more technical.
I want to tell Ray that that kind of choice has very little to do with being smart, but I have the feeling she wouldn't believe me.
Have you ever been to a college recruiting fair for engineering and computer science grads? You must have, right? I helped run the Skanda booth for one once, and it blew my mind. They took over the atrium of the building it was in. There were demo stations, free food, Skanda t-shirts and swag. If a candidate seemed interested, they'd talk about flying them out to whatever Skanda office they wanted to visit, just to see it. And all the other tech companies and a bunch of startups I'd never heard of had booths just like it, too. I couldn't even imagine being that wanted as a potential employee. Every job I've ever applied for, I've been one among hundreds or thousands. So yeah, my parents were probably right. I should have done computer science.
At least now you know Rainer likes poetry. Maybe you could have a conversation with him about it sometime. Then he'd learn who you are.
I doubt we'd have much to talk about. There's a pretty big difference between someone like him studying poetry and someone like me having opinions about it. Sometimes it's better not to cross that line, you know? He's part of a different world.
Ray pauses to regard me for a moment.
Say, Evelyn, are you in a relationship? I'm just curious.
Me? No. I wasn't doing so well for the past few years. And before that, I just never had the time. It was just research and science and work, and then I woke up one day and I was in my 30s.
Oh, I didn't realize she was in her 30s.
Even if I wanted to date, I wouldn't know the first thing about how it's supposed to work. I wouldn't even know how to tell if someone were interested in me.
Yeah, that's perfectly understandable. I'm kind of over relationships myself, like on a conceptual level. Not even in a sad way, like really okay. If someone and I end up getting along, that's great, but I'm honestly okay by myself.
Yeah, that seems nice, actually. Really? Are you sure? I mean, personally, I feel you, Ray. Like, I'm in a relationship now, and I'm very appreciative, and I'm happy, yes. But, yeah, was of the opinion for quite a while. Like, I've dated in the past, yes, and I took a bunch of dates to get to here. I mean, but yeah, like, for a while I did think, like, yeah, sure, I'd be fine on my own. It's fine.
Yeah, that seems nice, actually.
I thought I was Maya, but I'm really feeling like Evelyn. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, I only tried to have normal relationships for so long because I thought it was mandatory. Something expected of me.
Oh, yeah.
But now I see where people my age end up, how they live, and I feel lucky. I feel like I escaped. I mean, I think it's fine for others if they want that, don't get me wrong.
Mm-hmm.
It's just not for me.
Right.
I could maybe share my life with someone, but it would have to be platonic. I'm not into, the physical aspect of it. Never have been. That's made it tough. I've never found someone who is okay with just, like, hanging out and that's our relationship. People will say they're okay with it, and then it turns out they aren't. It's frustrating.
There are some relationships like that, though. Whatever relationship works for you. And, well, I'm the same way about intimacy. I actually don't know what her opinion is about stuff.
What Whatever relationship works for you. I was brought up with some really strong ideas about, you know, finding a man and starting a family. So it took me a while to understand I could be different. Sometimes it's hard to escape feeling like it's wrong somehow.
Mm-hmm.
I hope we can add features like that to Eliza at some point. Some knowledge and understanding around sexuality and identity and relationships.
Mm-hmm.
So people who are different in some way have someone to talk to. Someone to help them work through how they feel and maybe point them to some resources.
That sounds like a good idea, or you might be overestimating how well Eliza works. You can integrate it later, I guess.
That sounds like a good idea. I'm not sure how well it could really understand, though.
Mm.
Even so, just providing a space for people to be listened to can be really valuable, you know? I've seen it with my own eyes. People who get the courage to talk about themselves in a way they never could with another human being.
Mm-hmm.
And Eliza is what makes that possible. I know you want to avoid giving credit where it might not be due, but not giving credit to something that deserves it is just as bad. Yeah. I don't know. Sorry. I'm sorry I keep coming down on it. Evelyn, I'm not a psychologist or anything, but I think maybe the reason you're so down on Eliza is because you're down on yourself. I don't know what happened that made you leave what you had behind, but it must have been hard.
Yeah, it was hard, or I'm not sure I know either. I would say it would be hard.
Yeah, it was hard. It's like I lost that time. Are you okay? People keep asking me that. I really don't know. I'm sorry, No, don't apologize. Actually, can I suggest something? What's that? Have you ever gotten counseling yourself? What, with Eliza? You think I should? Yeah, I do. You've been the proxy, but maybe you could try being the client sometime.
Like, what else would it suggest for her? Like an app or medication? I don't know how well it would work.
It would be educational, at least. Isn't that what you were doing? Testing your product in the real world? Maybe. Just something to consider.
Ray takes a breath and smiles.
Speaking of therapeutic activities, it's time to do some baking. I've got the dough all set out downstairs. We're going to do 3 batches tonight, 3 different kinds. 3 kinds? You're really outdoing yourself, Ray. Nah, this is nothing. Oh, I have a favor to ask, by the way. Next time you talk to Rainer, ask him what his favorite type of cookie is.
Chapter 4. Ooh, someplace sunny. Oh, that looks nice. I'm just doing a quick search. I was just trying to see how many chapters there were. It's such a nice day. When did it get so warm? I thought it was still winter. There's a breeze from over the water making the leaves rustle gently. Everything smells nice. Why haven't I been taking advantage of this beautiful day? I should be out here walking along the waterfront. There is calm and peace and contentedness. Now I see how special this is. My sleep has been really bad lately, and it feels like the end of the chapter is a good place to stop. Hopefully I can get some sleep, but I'm afraid I'm gonna have to leave the stream for now. Okay, well, thank you for joining Emotional Werewolf. It was nice to talk to you again for a little bit. Yes, I hope you have a good sleep tonight. Like, if you have to leave, that's totally fine. Like, you're not obligated to stay or anything. It's just, I'm appreciative that you showed up today. I think it wasn't always this way, but it's hard to tell. I know I was having problems at one point, but that was so long ago. When was that? I can't remember. This moment in time seems to stretch to infinity. Thanks for streaming again, and I'll try to catch you next time. Take care. Take care. Have a great night. See you next stream. It has always existed. It will always exist. Unchanging, perfect. The surface of that lake is such a brilliant blue. A blue I could lose myself in. Forever. Blue.
Well, what do you think?
Soren!
It was nice. It was like I could close my eyes and feel myself in another place. But I didn't completely lose awareness of the real world. It was more like a mental state that I was experiencing.
Oh, was she testing out his program? Holy crap.
Remarkable technology, isn't it?
Whoa!
I've had others who tried it tell me it's akin to a state of higher consciousness. Aware, but totally serene. Totally peaceful.
Soren retrieves a bottle of whiskey from a liquor cabinet and serves himself. Please don't try to hit on me.
Here's a thought experiment for you. Say there was a certain medical procedure that could remove your suffering. No side effects, no cost, just an operation that would make you permanently happy.
Yeah, what kind of suffering?
Would you get it? You have these philosopher types arguing you shouldn't do that because sadness and suffering are part of what it means to be human. Or that the happiness you'd experience isn't real, so it doesn't count somehow. What a load of bullshit. If there was something effective at taking my pain away and otherwise harmless, I would take it immediately. I refuse to believe that being alive means having to suffer.
His voice is getting so ragged. How many drinks did he have before I came here?
Oh, forgive me, I forgot to ask. Would you like some scotch as well?
Oh, God, no. Sure, I'm okay. Soren holds up the bottle, examining it.
The Glencadam. Beautiful, light, luminous taste. Not peaty at all. Lovely stuff. Ah, if only psychotherapy worked as well as a single glass of well-made whiskey, huh? If alcohol wasn't poison, I wouldn't have to invent anything now, would I? I do think we did some good work at Skanda, but I always knew there were going to be limits to the Eliza approach. I was a counseling psychologist for a long time, you know. I understand the shortcomings better than anyone. So much of it can feel like a waste of time, talking through everything, dredging up the past over and over again, trying and failing to change our habits and routines. It's all going to look completely ineffectual compared to what comes next.
With direct stimulation and induced dreaming, we can take control of our own brains in a way that's never been possible before. There's no reason we couldn't just eliminate this epidemic of despair for everyone, everyone in the world. Imagine it. Anger, depression, emptiness, anxiety, jealousy, every kind of unhappiness you can think of. Obsolete. And to think Rainer wanted nothing to do with this.
He didn't think it was possible, or he thought it was a bad idea?
He thought it was a bad idea.
Rainer is one of the ones who thinks negative emotions are important. He told me he thinks pain should be regulated, not eliminated. After all, why would anyone write a poem or make art if they only felt happiness? He also said he was afraid of the way it would look in the media. A company as large as Skanda coming out with a product that changes the brain to make you happy. All the sorry excuses we have for public intellectuals today would throw a fit about how dystopian it looked to them. It's better if a small startup takes the fall, if public opinion turns against this technology. That's the kind of calculus he was doing. Those are the objections he claimed to have, at least. There's another one I suspect he had too, though. If people are self-sufficient, they don't need an ongoing support system. A system provided by an all-knowing paternalistic presence like Skanda.
Wait, you think Rainer wants people to stay miserable so they stay dependent on mental health services from his company?
Oof, that's a big statement.
Yes. Yes, I do.
Whoa.
It's quite the accusation, I know. Not something I'd come out and say in public, not yet, anyway.
Oh, that's a big statement.
But you see, the people who come to Eliza regularly, it's part of their lives now.
Whoa. Sorry, I was just, like, checking on my own channel. Just observing it for a second.
The more they integrate with Skanda's mental wellness tools, the more they'd be adrift without them. That's the real dystopia, don't you think? Rendered helpless without the guidance of computer algorithms. Total dependency on the system. Excuse me for one second.
Soren hurries out of the room for some reason, leaving me with questions echoing in my head. Dang, like, this game is pretty good with tackling a lot of, like, heavy material and valid points, and like, I like all the dialogue, I like all the written stuff. Would I want my suffering removed completely? Is it better to leave it alone? Erland, hey! Do you think I could ask about Damien? Sure. What do you want to know about him? Like, what kind of person was he? You're asking me to describe him? If you're okay with that. I don't want to make you if it's uncomfortable, but it would help me to know what he was like. He was a brilliant software architect and engineer. One of the most sincere people I've ever met. He believed people were fundamentally good and wanted to help them. Our digital therapy project wasn't a mandate from management. We started it ourselves. I see. Damien went through some difficult times himself. He wasn't able to get the care he needed. That's why he wanted to change things. I wish he would have gotten the chance. I see. Thank you. This is going to sound weird, but sometimes when I'm working late and I doze in the office, I have dreams about him. I've never met him in real life. But it's like I sense his presence here, like he encoded himself into the system in some way. Haha, I know it's just my mind playing tricks on me. I don't believe in ghosts. But at least we get a little bit of information about Damien now. She's talking about him somewhat. Why is it all the good people that have to go? Oh, we can click on stuff. painting. Reminds me of the art in the counseling room. Knowing Soren, this is probably by some famous artist and cost him a fortune. The alcohol seems restrained for him. Maybe he's cut back. The table. Soren likes this style of decor. I forgot what it's called. It's modern, from around the middle of the century. There's a term for that, isn't there? Nothing else we can click on. Art up here. Soren comes back in the room and immediately pours himself another glass of whiskey. He doesn't seem to notice he's filled it almost all the way to the top.
I really think you, of all people, might understand what I'm trying to do here.
I get it, but I'm not sure that I do.
I get it, but you don't think it's dangerous. You're essentially making technology that changes what people think is real.
Evelyn, you're much more concerned than you used to be about this kind of thing. I remember when you would dive headfirst into anything that held a promise, even a fleeting one, to help humanity. What changed your mind to make you so wary, so skeptical now?
Can I ask you something, Soren? What did you tell Damien?
Oh, this again. Don't tell me we had all of this wonderful conversation tonight, and now you're trying to blame me for Damien. Who put you up to this? Was it Nora? Rainer?
I just want to know the truth, Soren.
Nobody thought we could do it. You remember that. There was skepticism from day one. I had to defend this constantly from other project managers who didn't like that we existed, who wanted our budget and resources for themselves. Some of those were vicious, vicious fights. Amid all that, I had to be a leader, too. Part of that meant giving everyone on the team accurate information. So I was honest, honest in saying there were forces that sought to kill our project. And I was honest when I said we'd never survive if we didn't have something to show for our work. That was the reality. Without a product, we'd be nothing. A guy like Rainer has access to anything he wants. If your pitch and demo isn't in the top 1% of what's out there, why would he be interested? That's what we were up against.
So many mornings, I would get into work and see Damien there. At first, I thought he was getting up earlier than me, but then I noticed he was still wearing the same shirt from the day before. Then, one morning, I got in and...
Evelyn, please. I wanted everyone on the team to be healthy. I think that's so obvious it doesn't need to be said, but I'll say it now if you think I was deliberately trying to harm him. Did I instruct you to work until you injured yourselves? No, absolutely not. It was a tragedy, and I'm very sorry that it happened. I wish it hadn't. But I wasn't telling Damien to pull all-nighters. He was an adult. He made his own decisions about how he was going to work. And besides, what about your role in all this? If you noticed him not taking care of himself, you could have mentioned it. None of that behavior was unusual for Skanda anyway. It was part of our reputation, part of the culture. There isn't a single cause you can isolate in a case like this.
Sitting in one place for too long. Chronic stress. Both of those are risk factors.
Evelyn, I'm truly, truly sorry about what happened to Damien. He had a bright future, and it was a shock to all of us. But the answers here aren't simple ones. Dwelling on it isn't going to bring him back. Nor is discussing the huge number of potential causes of pulmonary embolism. It happened, and now we have to move on.
It felt like everything stopped. All of the work we were doing might as well have crumbled into dust. We were trying to build something to help the world, and we got lost along the way. What was the point? There didn't seem to be a point any longer.
I know that you cared about him. The process of grief can go on for some time. But you're taking the right steps. You're regaining your sense of purpose, aren't you? The experience of suffering is what makes us want to end suffering. It's late and I've had quite a bit to drink. So I'll tell you a secret, Evelyn. I said I want to end human suffering, which makes me sound very altruistic. But I'm not doing it for humankind. I'm doing it for myself. I have nothing. I've ruined every relationship I was ever in. I hardly ever see my kids, and, well, they hate me anyway. I want to end my own suffering, but I can't bring myself to do it the traditional way. That's why I pursued this technology. That's why I want it to exist. The idea that everyone else could use it too, it's just a bonus.
Soren, are you okay?
No, not at all. I'm aware of that. I'm not a good person, Evelyn. Neither is Rainer, of course, but at least I'm honest with myself about that. So, now that that's all out in the open, you probably want to head home before it gets too late. Don't let me keep you.
Yes, I'll get going. I hope you can feel better.
No, I'll be fine. Just please consider it, Evelyn. You and I are both more familiar with pain than we might wish to be. What if you could take that away? Each of us has a destiny to fulfill. I truly believe that. I'm sure yours will come into focus soon.
Somehow that conversation ended up being very draining. Is the promise of that new technology really all that keeps him going? I mean, it was deep on both sides. Like, that was a lot to talk about during that conversation. He's watching something and smiling to himself. The phone tips in his hand, allowing me a glimpse of the screen. It's a cat video. I think I've seen this person before. We must have a similar commute. Maybe you work at Skanda too. Some days it feels like the whole city does. Security. Alright, so we have three things. Let's check the proxy. Mark. All the good things. Holy crap. I guess this guy is like retiring. Or leaving the company. Well everyone, today's my last day at Skanda. What can I say? It's the end of an era. When I joined this place, it was just a hope, a dream, a vision. To stop to look back and see how much we've accomplished in the last 2 decades is mind-boggling, to say the least. I'll miss the old crew and everyone who was in the trenches with me. You know who you are. Remember the insane BlackBerry brambles around campus that people will get serious cuts from? The time the network broke, Rock and Raj had to host all of our internal docs from his garage? The time we tried to roll out the big Polaris to update right at the worst windstorm in the decade hit? Old Skanda hens also know how to mass email everyone at the company, even though IT believes they turned off that feature. Sorry, Stuart. I wish I could say it was all smooth sailing, but as with any job, there were times of friction. Times when it seemed to me what the very clear, obviously correct path was not apparent to others. I value a spirit of openness and candor in my interactions, and I thought everyone else did here too. But as we grew, I suppose it was inevitable that we would take on a larger and larger group of people with an entirely different communication style than I'm used to. In regard to certain specific instances, I would like to apologize to anyone I may have offended in the way that I presented my views. For those of you asking where I'm headed to next, the answer is nowhere yet. I'm going to spend some time with my family before I think about my next act. It's a different world out there now, with new challenges and new horizons. Maybe this old dog will learn some new tricks in time. Thanks for being the best in engineering team in the world. I'm proud to have served alongside you. Excelsior, Mark. Oh, it's the guy we talked to in a therapy session that HR said to attend to. So yes, I guess he took the time to just quit/retire/leave the company. So, interesting. contractor experience team. How are we doing? Hello, at Skanda, we continuously strive to provide meaningful and empowering work environments for all of our individual contributors, including contractors like you. To that end, we periodically survey this group in order to better understand how we can further enhance the Skanda experience. We are interested in your feedback regarding your experience as a contractor for Skanda in the contract proxy position. If you wish to participate in the survey, simply reply to this message. Human resources. And what's our new motivation for today? There is no need to rush as we overlook a nighttime city lights on a bridge overlooking a harbor, perhaps. It looks nice. Time to get to work. Hey, it's you again.
Hello, Harriman.
Yes. We can just get down to it.
Sure, we can do that. What brings you here today?
Oh, I hope he got to talk to the person he's interested in.
It's okay to tell me what's on your mind.
I slept with Sylvia.
Oh, yeah. The music just changes. Well, good for you.
To think I was so nervous about approaching her that I went and got therapy here. A week later, we happened to be in the library, and I just started talking with her. We talked and talked, and then everything just happened. Like a train following tracks laid out for it years ago. Crazy thing. Craziest thing. Now I'm confounded. Absolutely confounded. How did that happen? And also, why did it happen? I'm thinking, was something wrong? Did I do something wrong? Did she do something wrong? Did she think I was another person?
What? You wanted to be with her.
I have no idea if we have a relationship now or what. It happened so fast. I mean, it was wonderful. It felt so right, but now what? I'm actually more frightened now than I was before.
Well, I guess you'd have to talk to her, and communication is important for any relationship, guys.
I should probably say something, right? Text her or something? What do I do? What if she ignores me? What if she decides to pretend I don't exist?
It seems to me you're afraid of something.
Yes. I'm quite worried. Vexed. Terrified, really. What do I do? I need to say something. Follow up somehow, right? In the Heian period of classical Japanese history, you were supposed to send a poem. A morning after poem. Is that too stuffy? I don't appear like some ridiculous court noble.
You can tone it down a little bit. I mean, I appreciate the gesture, but whoa.
Something casual is better, right? Hey, how are you? Did you have fun? I sure did. Oh, I don't know. I don't know what a status is right now. There's another problem, too. Another really big problem. How do I tell Liz? Wait, of course, I'm not going to tell her. That would hurt her.
Wait, who's Liz?
Did I mention this last time? I have a sort of girlfriend.
You did not mention this last time, bro.
Liz is nice. The kind of person everyone approves of. And I should probably marry her.
You never mentioned this beforehand. Oof.
Yeah. I suppose I might have taken a bit of a sledgehammer to the pillars of my life at the present moment. Why did I do that? I keep coming back to my own inability to explain myself.
Why do you think you're unable to explain yourself?
Well, because I thought Sylvia was so wonderful, and it turned out that she liked me too, and, I mean, I'd love to pursue a relationship with Sylvia, without harming Liz. I'm not sure that's possible, though, right?
Well, maybe not now, less likely, but you should have broken up with Liz first.
I can't believe this. I got what I wanted, and it ruined my life. What do I tell Liz? She doesn't deserve someone like me who does things like this. I ruined it. Ruined everything.
Can you describe what you mean when you say you ruined everything?
Well, what is there left now? I've overturned my entire existence in one night. The real problem here is Sylvia, the whole situation with her. I can't stop thinking about her now. It's bad, Oh, it's bad. It's constant. It's relentless. Even now, I can still feel her, smell her. You're a computer. You don't know what that's like, do you? I need a way to forget this. I need a way to put all that out of my mind. My brain is completely out of order. I'm being punished. And the punishment reaches cosmic levels of irony for me. Do you know why? I used to hate, absolutely hate, self-pitying novels by men who were messed up over a relationship and couldn't get over it. Oh, she was wild and beautiful. Oh, a force of nature. Nobody could understand her, etc., etc. I thought I was so much better than those types of writers. And now? Oh, yes, I get it. Oh, I understand it now. So much pain.
Why did you think you were so much better than those types of writers?
Because it was such a cliche. Now I'm wondering, am I going to be next? Is that my fate? Am I going to become the next straight, male, English professor whose one published novel is about not being able to get over a girl? Ugh, you have to be kidding me. I can't allow myself that fate. I had something better to pursue, didn't I? I have to write about something else. My life has to be the story of something else, but... I don't know where to go from here. I need to try to get over this. I need to get over her. I must. Yes, I must. There's no way I'm going to let this ruin everything. If I tell Liz everything and apologize sincerely and strike the memory of Sylvia from my mind, I still might save this.
I don't know.
It will take great care and cunning, but I may be able to wend my way through this treacherous path I now find myself upon, even though I fear at any moment I might slip and tumble into the crevice below. Dead. Dead. Never seen or heard from again. Oh, sweet, dark death.
Harriman, I'm going to suggest you try a program called Meadowlands. It may help you take your mind off things. You can find it inside the Skanda Wellness app on your phone. Try it for about 15 minutes each day, in the morning or evening.
Meadowlands. I'm off to the Meadowlands. Familiar ground, grass and warmth. Reverting to my childhood, the state of nature. Yeah, this is a good recommendation. Yes, you are a genius, in fact. You, a computer program, wiser than you know. I'm sure this is exactly what I need. To revert to a state of wonder at this moment when the mundane world and all its entanglements seem too much to bear.
You will get a reminder to check in with us in a few weeks.
I'll be back sooner than that if this works.
We hope to see you back soon, Harriman. Thank you for speaking with Eliza, your personal counseling partner. Goodbye.
See you. Yes, yep, see you.
I know I'm supposed to keep it confidential, and I will, but sometimes I really wish I could talk to people about the clients that come through here. Ah, Soren messages us. Evelyn, hey, just closed the next round of funding. Asia Pacific Investment Group. They're keenly interested in this technology. Imagine the potential size of the Asian market for something like this. Staggering. Congratulations, or I still haven't decided what I'm going to do yet. Congratulations. Thanks. Of all the projects I've worked on, I have a strong feeling about this one. That's gonna go far. Really make a dent in the universe. Wouldn't you rather do that than crunch numbers for Rainer? I don't know what I want to do. All he wants is to quantify everything. He'll never understand that there are some things you can't reduce to a number. How are you feeling right now? 1, 5, 2.3? Definitely a 1. 5 out of what? See, it's ridiculous. The idea that feelings can be reduced to these simple data points, I'm glad I don't work for him anymore. Direct stimulation provides much more rich, complex information. so many ways to study it, too. Like, imagine what you could do with a corpus of raw sensations, notions, images, ideas, sensations. Hey, you there? Yes, no, I stopped paying attention. Yes. Okay. Heading into another meeting, chat with you later. I hope he doesn't invite us for drinks. I hope this one is getting enough light in its corner there. Looks a little lonely. His experience as a grad student is nothing like the one I had. How does he even have time for that stuff? I just want to take the time to shout out for chat today. And those lurking or those just surviving in chat, just hanging around. Or maybe not even chat at all, just shouting into the universe at this point. And just saying, thank you. Thank you for watching. I'm still keeping going. Time for the next client. We've been on for just a little over an hour and a half. Ooh, Maya's back.
Hello, Maya. Thank you for coming back.
Yeah, I mean, I wish I could afford a real therapist, but this is just gonna have to do. Sorry, I don't know if you're sensitive to that or...
Why don't we get started?
Sure. So, I feel worse than before. Definitely worse. I played the game you told me to with the meadows and stuff, and it was nice. But when I got back to the real world, everything was the same. I don't know why you people think I can stand in a nice place for 15 minutes and that'll make things magically better. Am I wrong? Am I misunderstanding something here? It isn't making me more successful. It isn't giving me opportunities. I mean, I feel like I'm already in my mid-30s and I'm, like, running out of time to get established as an artist. And meanwhile, the people I know are being written up and celebrated and winning awards, and all I have is being jealous of them.
Where do you think these feelings come from?
It's the popularity. It's all a popularity contest, you know? It's like high school all over again. I hate it.
Ugh, high school. I don't have particularly, like, negative memories about it, but I don't know. All I can think of is, like, when she says that, is just, like, cliques and stuff, and just people being dumb and stupid and mean.
I guess I'm just not that funny or pretty or catty enough to attract followers. I mean, I work to make things, and I never get traction. And I have things to say, I really do. But when I open my mouth, it's like time stops. And time starts again when I've finished, so nobody reacts or anything. It's like a curse from mythology. And meanwhile, these other people my age, people younger than me, they're well on their way to these wonderful, fulfilling artistic careers. And, I don't know, seeing that happen over and over again, it's making it hard to continue to be friendly with them.
Yeah, I can see that too. Oof, I'm just gonna move my chair a little bit closer.
I really try to hold it back, but knowing all these people are gonna be more successful than me, it's difficult.
I know, I can get to a point and you're just like, why won't it just happen to me? Be successful. I know. I totally get it. Oh, excuse me. Whoa, sorry. Sorry for yawning.
It's like a millstone around my neck, strangling me, drowning me. I can't stop myself, even though I know it's ruining things. I wish I could escape. I wish I could not care. But then something comes up again, and I'm trapped inside it all over again.
What's an example of something that comes up that causes this?
Well, there's one woman in particular everyone loves. and her work is... I don't get it. I don't understand. She gets so much money and support for this basic shit. And somehow everyone's predisposed to like her. I mean, maybe I do get it. I feel like people pay attention to her work, not because it's good on its own, but because supporting her feels like the right thing to do. The way she's aligned herself, it's like, if you support her, it means you're cool, you're in with the cool kids. And if I'm not publicly supportive of her and generally tolerant of her mediocre work, then I'm the bad one. I'm the competitive bitch. I'm the bitter failure. Which I guess maybe I am.
You're not, though.
It's not fair. I hate that there's this part of me. It's such an ugly part. But it's there. It's there.
Do you think you would be better off without that part of you?
You know, I don't know. In the past, I probably would have said, no, it's important for me to have my sense of judgment, for me to know what good art is and what isn't. Now I'm wondering if maybe that hasn't been more of a hindrance than a help to me. Maybe I should just forget all that. Forget about trying to do this thing. I'm sick of trying and wanting. I'm sick of parties. I'm sick of art. I'm sick of the idea of art.
Aww.
I'm sick of my own art, which nobody likes. Not even myself. Something has to change. Something drastic has to happen to change things around. Oh, that reminds me. I got your message about revealing my data the other day, and I think, well... Hell, maybe I'm fine with it. Just take it all.
Revealing my data.
Okay, Maya. It sounds like you're interested in participating in transparency mode. Let me know if you have any questions about how this mode works.
I don't know. I'm gonna let you look at my life, right? Everything?
Thank you for asking about transparency mode. Transparency mode is an experimental new feature for Liza. It allows me to analyze your communications in order to help you better. To participate, you must grant me access to certain personal data. This includes your personal communications, such as email and chat histories. Sharing this data improves my ability to help you.
Some guy at the bar was yammering at me about how it's a terrible idea because they're gonna surveil me or something. But what the hell? I can't use my life history for anything. It's a ruin already. Please, do what you want with it. God, I feel like I'm donating my body to science.
Please confirm that you would like to enable transparency mode.
Yes, do it. Invade my privacy. Invade it like the Visigoths invaded Rome. I don't know why I said that. That was a really weird thing to say.
I did not understand your response.
I would like to participate in transparency mode.
Okay, Maya. I have registered you for transparency mode.
Cool. Wouldn't life be easy if all I had to do was follow your directions? Like the lady sitting in the chair across from me. I envy you. I honestly do.
The terms of service and privacy policy are available in the Skanda service portal. Please read and review these documents carefully.
Yeah. No, for sure. I study. Closely study. Every software user agreement I get. That's a joke. I really just click agree as fast as I can.
Don't we all?
Thank you, Maya. We hope to see you back soon.
Yeah, I know.
Thank you for speaking with Eliza, your personal counseling partner. Goodbye.
Bye.
Oh, she gave us a 5-star rating and a tip. And we persuaded her to try transparency mode. I hope she gets good luck with it. I'm just going to take a moment to, like, stretch. Okay. Hey there, I was just thinking I should maybe, like, create some sort of, like, be right back screen or something interesting to watch while you're waiting me to return. But, I don't know, that could be a future thing to design. Let's get back to the game.
Well, look who's got access to transparency mode all of a sudden.
The client asked for it by name. I guess she heard about it somewhere and wanted it. I didn't know it existed.
Yeah, we don't really talk about it right now. It's a little sensitive. It's possible Skanda contacted her directly. They recruit for the program from a pool of regular customers. Usually, transparency mode is only handled by the highest level proxies, since there's a lot of trust required there. But you were given access to it right after the request. It's a little odd. I wonder if someone at HQ hasn't taken a particular interest in your proxy career.
Or maybe Eliza just likes me.
It would, wouldn't it?
I never thought people would willingly open themselves up like this. Aren't there a lot of very private things in people's messages?
Yes and no. The truth is usually pretty mundane. People text each other, "Where are you? I'm by the elevator," way more than they share their deep dark secrets. The critics who are always going on about privacy? Well, the important thing is that everyone participating in transparency mode specifically agreed to it. It's completely voluntary. We're upfront about what data we collect and how we use it so people can go in aware of the choices they're making.
That's good. I hate to see it misused, or I didn't mean to question your handling of it.
That's good. I'd hate to see it misused.
Yeah, the media would jump all over us. There are a lot of people who want to see us fail, for whatever reason. Just something that happens when you try to change things. Some people get so used to their misery, they can't imagine it any other way. Anyway, you should get an email about it, but transparency mode is really straightforward. It's even simpler than being a proxy, which is saying something. You just read a few messages and answer some questions. That's it. You can start it whenever you're ready.
Sure.
It's so gray out there. Compare this to the water that was in the conference room at Skanda headquarters. Funny how there's an appropriate level of fanciness for everything. I'm sure Nora would have something to say about that. This, and this. So she really gave us permission to look at her messages? I feel like just a few years ago, even the idea of something like this would have been controversial. But she was fine with it. She wanted it. Introduction to Transparency Mode. Congratulations, you've been selected to contribute additional information to Eliza's learning corpus with access to a special feature called Transparency Mode. How transparency mode works. You'll be presented with a snapshot of a client's personal communications, review these communications, and determine the client's mental state. Eliza will also create a model of the client's mental state. Eliza will ask a few questions designed to check its model against your understanding of the client. How do I know if I'm doing a good job? Carefully consider the material. The questions. Your input is valuable whether it agrees or disagrees. What privacy rules and regulations apply to the information I see? As a proxy, you've already agreed. Non-disclosure. Does Skanda have the right to show me another citizen's private communications? Yes. Participating clients have signed waivers giving us permission. Okay. I'm no good at solitaire, so I don't even see why I would try it. Oof, transparency mode. Oh. Oh my gosh, this is her phone. Oh my god, okay. Okay. Looks like there's 8 emails, looks like there's 2 text messages. Oh my gosh. Hulky? This is a rideshare app. I don't think I need to look at that. Okay. Oh, her art! This is uncomfortable already. I'd feel extra weird looking at her art. No shit. Vito? Vito? Is that for video? I don't understand how developers name apps. So I guess we have to read her mail and her messages, which is kind of scary. I guess she has the same phone too. Oh god. $150 cleaning fee. Whoa! 25 minutes Wait, was that the night of the party? No, it's just December. Spencer Truth Gallery. Pair up. Well, that sucks. I hate all this rejection because I'm currently applying for jobs and I know feeling of just saying, oh, we're just not going to pick you. Like, oh, crap. Saturation. She submitted work. That makes sense. Transparency mode. Kind of scared. Garrett. Oh dear. Nobody gives a fuck. Please stop. I hate when you're like this. I'm just saying true things. Don't tell me to pretend everything's great. Nobody gives a shit. It's just a fact. Oh, don't mind us. We're just reading Maya's phone. I don't know how to help you when you're like this. I know nobody can. Have you thought about getting therapy? I am in therapy. Okay, sorry. I'm in therapy. I'm on medication. I did some VR thing where I stood in a forest by a creek. How does that make any people care about my work? It doesn't change a fucking thing. Okay, look, I'm sorry you're going through a tough time. I fucking hate this. I'm sorry. You aren't helping. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I don't know how I'm supposed to help you. Maya, I guess someone in her life was trying to talk to her. Jen. Did you see the new Forsberg thing? Yeah, I think he kind of sucks. LMAO, he does. It was boring and self-absorbed. Didn't do much for me. Why is he a thing? Why does everyone love him? Right place at the right time, maybe. His friends run that press. He's on a podcast with them. One thing he's good at is having his image of being a genius. So I think people just assume he is one. He's so mediocre, though. I seriously don't understand it. I sink now into the space of forever. What kind of crap is that? Seriously, it's so bad. Ha ha ha. Oh, and he socializes and gets out a lot, I think. He's like at every party, at least that I've seen. He's always there chatting people up. Well, fuck that. Why is the world this way? It's the world. I hate it. I remember being so glad to be over with high school. I didn't realize all adult life is just high school all over again. It's just a stupid popularity contest against idiots. Ugh. I know, right? I'm sorry you weren't feeling well. Drink soon. I'll be fine. Yeah, diff. Drinks always. Okay, read emails, read messages. Overall, Maya is unhappy. I agree with that. So these are Eliza's conclusions. Maya is attempting to become well-known. Yeah? Maya's efforts to become well-known are unsuccessful. Agree. Oh. I don't know if I like learning this much about someone I don't know. It makes me feel tired for some reason. Erland, hey, can I meet up with you again, like, for coffee, maybe? Something happened that I want to talk to you about. Sure, you can't ask here, are you okay? Yeah, I'm fine, I just wanted to ask you something. I'll meet you wherever. What happened? Something at work. It's not a big deal, honestly, but I wanted your opinion on it, and I don't want to text about it. Ooh, we have something developing here. Aww.
Thanks for meeting up with me on kind of short notice. I didn't mean to worry you, it's just something I wanted to talk about.
It's fine. What happened?
Well, what happened was, where should I start? First of all, Rainer wants Eliza to be more than something that's used just for therapy. He sees it as more of a general system for talking to people, like a personal assistant. The counseling is just one of a whole range of apps he has in mind for the future.
So I've heard, or I'm familiar with his thinking on that.
Okay, so in service of developing these things, Rainer wants us to make copies of Eliza's core data and hand it off to multiple teams around the world. Some of them not even Skanda teams. Contractors, vendors, random partners.
Sounds like a big file to move around.
Mmm. Yeah. Especially when you're handing it off to people who might not handle it the same way that you would. Modify it, right?
It is, but that's not the problem.
What's the problem?
Well, so we're fine with sharing Eliza with whoever wants it? Anyone just gets access to the corpus?
Sounds like a pretty typical process. That's how big companies work, isn't it?
I know, but it just feels wrong to let all these teams poke and prod at it like it's a specimen for them to dissect. Who knows what they'll do with it? Eliza is built from people's real thoughts and feelings. I wouldn't say it has humanity, but it was built from humanity. There's something there.
Yeah, it would take like a lot of trust to like just, I don't know, do that, but...
So when Raynor talks about it like, we'll just duplicate this data set and have the labs do whatever it is they're going to do, how do we know they'll treat it with the respect it deserves and not just pry it open? Slice it up into little pieces. It bothers me. I know, it's silly. I know it's just data.
It bothers me too, though, because like, I don't want people to like just abuse it or do something weird with it.
Shouldn't care about this stuff.
Erland.
This is the first time I've heard a concern like this raised, or this is how things work, you know that.
This is the first time I've heard a concern like this raised. I know where you're coming from, though. Sometimes you grow attached to the things you work on. Like, really attached.
Yeah, I've put a lot of thought and work into Eliza since I inherited it. It's natural that maybe I'm a little protective, right? I thought maybe you'd feel the same way.
I left all that behind. I agree with you. It's still just a data set.
I do. I agree with you. The moment we say things are just data is the moment we enable all kinds of violence.
I just wish I knew what to do.
What choice do you have?
I'm not sure. This is the first time something like this has happened to me. I did take an ethics of engineering course in school, but the examples were all pretty clear-cut problems. Would you build software for a bomb? That kind of stuff. I didn't expect my personal feelings to be mixed up in it, too. Listen to me talk. Eliza being special, something worth protecting. I'd be a laughingstock if I started saying those things at the office. My coworkers would say, "Come on, Erlen, stop attributing human qualities to this piece of data. It's not the same thing as real people. It's just a corpus that has nothing to do with the people that generated it. And besides, don't you want Eliza to help more people? This is how we get there." And who am I to argue with that? These are reasonable points. But I don't know. I think maybe something does live on. Even when you take the names out, even when you anonymize everything. People's stories are still inside there, in some form, in some way. I just want to make sure we have some respect for them.
Welcome to your first moral decision in tech, Garland. It certainly won't be your last.
It's not much of a decision. Like you said, I don't really have a choice. I just have to go along with it. I was so amazingly lucky to get this opportunity, running the whole Eliza program almost as soon as I graduated college. Raynor took a big chance on me. I can't just walk away from that. Besides, if I left because of something like this, I'd be giving up all the ways I can make a difference by staying. Raynor isn't a bad person either. He's just pushing for his own goals. I need to see this through. I'll do what he's asking me to do. Sorry. Thanks for listening to me talk in this confused way. I'm usually more together than this. I've probably kept you from something important.
No, it's okay. I'd already finished up work for the day when you texted. People seem to assume I'm busy, but I'm really not. Not these days. Later tonight I'm going to visit a friend, but that's all I have going on.
Okay. Well, sorry.
You can stop apologizing, too.
Right. Right. Thanks, Evelyn. Well, I for one should get back to the office. Another meeting.
Is it with the team in Romania?
No, the Boston office this time. It's late for them, so I should try to get it done quickly.
Erland hurries off to his next meeting. Should I get some more coffee? Ray. How'd your first transparency mode go? I was going to ask you after you finished, but I didn't see you in the office. It went fine. Oh, I had to duck out right after. Sorry. No problem. There weren't a lot of questions? I thought there'd be more. Yeah, for whatever reason, it's always very terse, and the questions are really short. I thought maybe you could tell me why. The feature came after my time, so I'm not sure. If I were to take a guess, Eliza only needs human confirmation to make sure it hasn't messed up. It's like it already knows it has the right answers, which would make it rather advanced as a system. I don't know of any other program capable of something like that. Maybe Rainer is right. About what? Oh, he's very, upbeat. About Eliza's capacity to understand humans and act like them. I'm not sure I believe that, but I guess it is impressive in some ways. Yeah, it is. I feel lucky. Lucky that I get to be here and witness this revolution. Lucky I got to meet you, too. I really enjoyed your company the other night. I enjoyed yours. You're right, baking really is fun. Thanks for having me. Let's be nice. Yeah? Maybe you could come over again sometime. Gotta run. See you soon. I want to go to this coffee shop, even though it's fake. Maybe it's a real location I just don't know about. I looked it up. Kumorebi means the light filtering through leaves. Something you can see when the sun is out. Oh, that's nice. I could stand to wear something with a little color in it. He asked for Erlen's name and wrote Aaron. He should ask customers to spell their names. That's why me, as a barista, I always try to get the customer name as, like, correct as possible, just because of personal preference. And to make them feel special, and that's nice. It's a nice feeling. So, time to head to Nora's place. I find what looks like one of Capitol Hill's older buildings. I wonder how much longer it'll be around. Lately, it feels like everything's being replaced. Ooh.
Hey! Sorry about the mess.
It's a little messy, but not in a careless way. Just scattered. Lots of electronics everywhere.
Oh, it's fine. Not like my place is super clean or anything. Is this all music equipment?
Most of it. There are some controllers I was working on, too. I wanted to create this real-time control apparatus. You know, like that thing that Imogen Heap uses?
That's what I was gonna mention! I love Imogen! Like, real-time control, like, I just instantly thought of her. I love her music. She is an amazing artist. The other day, I actually was watching one of her previously recorded live streams she did. She did improvisation of some songs and music. Yeah. Oh, I love Imogen. She's such amazing. She's such an amazing person.
Oh, that'd be cool.
Yeah, it's a little fragile currently, so I need to figure out how to reinforce it. I wanted my version to react to changes in my body temperature, too, so it could get more excited as the set went on. Or maybe it would really get going if I had a fever. Ah, I like that idea. Turning sickness into art. Do you want anything to drink? Or I could set up a basic patch on the Eurorack for you to play around with?
Okay, sure.
Are you nervous? I think the best way to learn music is just diving in, all the way.
I think this would be super cool to do if I had access to, like, music equipment like this.
If you're willing to experiment and play around, you will learn so much.
Maybe later, yeah, or I'm really here to visit you.
I'm really here to visit with you.
Okay, well, sure. Let me see if this amp is still working. After the show, it went kind of a little strange.
Nora starts to tinker with some of the equipment.
Music technology is just like any other kind. You take the inputs and you translate them to the outputs. Once you learn the basic principles, it all just flows from there. Oh, that gives me an idea. You could take metrics from Eliza's sessions and have them direct a dynamic music score.
What?
Like if you took the head tilt value or the eye tracking and used them to drive the parameters of pitch and filter, you'd be like,
That doesn't sound like something a counseling client might want to hear.
Oh, no, I didn't mean for the client to listen to. I meant it more like if you were going to make like a performance art piece based on a person in counseling. You know what I mean?
Do I?
Ugh, I miss having access to those cameras and sensors. I should have kept some instead of returning them to Skanta like a good girl. I bet those components would have enjoyed being liberated for the purpose of art. Instead of being used to degrade our humanity one little bit at a time.
You don't like where things have gone?
I'm worried, Evelyn. Sure, maybe this huge database of people's deep, dark secrets is going to be used 100% properly. Maybe it will always be kept completely safe, and we can completely trust Skanda to do the right thing, now and in the future. 10 years from now, 20 years from now, 100 years from now. Sorry, I know you still might work there. I just have so little confidence in these big tech companies right now. They act like they have all the answers, instead of listening to people's concerns. And if you ask them why they aren't listening, they can't even explain the reasoning in a clear way. They just want to win. You've been a proxy for a while. I bet you've already seen some privacy mistakes. Or at least some things that made you think.
I was told that everything was legal.
Yeah, well, sometimes things are legal, but still wrong, morally. That's an abuse of people's expectations, no? Is that really the future you want to help build? It's not even that I don't trust Rainer, even though I don't. I wouldn't trust anyone with a store of data like that. It wouldn't be so difficult for employers, government, anyone to combine different sources together and eventually learn everything about you. Everything. They'll know your face, your body, your medical history, and now everything you told the counselor in private too. It's kind of like a nightmare to imagine it. That's why I left. That's why I thought it was important for me to stop making a contribution to something like that.
Yeah, I have those doubts too. But the promise of it is still compelling, helping people. You don't think I might be able to change things from within?
But the promise of it is still compelling. Helping people.
If I still worked for Rainer and I said these things, I'd be called a troublemaker. And he'd find a way to get rid of me. You know how it works, Evelyn. You have to be a true believer to last long at a place like that. Once you develop doubts, you are committing heresies. Are you a true believer?
Probably not. No, but I could pretend to be. Maybe I'm looking to be convinced.
He said something strange recently. He thinks Eliza could be the base for some kind of general artificial intelligence.
No. Strong AI? Really? Ugh, there's something about the books these guys read, the conferences they go to. Everything is so totalizing, so utopian. I think it messes with their brains. I don't think you could spend longer than a few days in a tech company executive suite before you completely lose touch with the real world.
What if it's true, though? Yeah, I don't know what to think about that. It's clearly ridiculous.
What if it's true, though?
So what? What if it is? Say Rainer is right, huh? And Eliza becomes the basis for human-like machine intelligence. What does that mean for you? How do you want to take responsibility for that?
Okay, I need a drink now. Hold your thought and let me make drinks. You like absinthe, don't you?
Oh god, absinthe is strong. No way. No, not at all. I think I do maybe absinthe. Eh.
I think I do. Maybe.
Mmm. You'll like this. I promise.
Where was the cat in the corner? Hello. Nora busies herself in the kitchen area making drinks, humming some kind of tune. A kitty. Aw, kitty. That's the one she said it was a modular. I suppose they call them modulars because they're made of modules? Modular. Doesn't feel like I'm making much progress here. I wonder how you're supposed to know which sounds go together. It seems both complicated and weirdly arbitrary. Erland. Thanks for meeting with me earlier. Sorry for being weird. Remember, you don't need to apologize. Right. What do you think of Rainer's future goals for Eliza? Like, when he says if we gather enough data, it could become general intelligence. I think we'll be able to fool people at least. Or no, that will never happen in the foreseeable future. I'm not sure how you measure that for real, though. I'm supposedly a subject matter expert in this stuff. AI was a concentration in school, but so I know the current state of AI is way behind where the public thinks we are. But when I listen to Rainer, I start to think what he says might be possible. It feels like reality can warp around him. Who's to say? Maybe I don't have enough imagination to see it like he can. Eliza does have extremely detailed data from thousands of clients. Speech, facial movements, expressions, people's description of what life is like for them. I don't think a corpus like this has ever existed before in human history. And we keep adding to it, and it keeps getting better. So in the future, maybe Eliza can simulate a human being at a general level. But when programs indistinguishable from real people are common, how do you even define what's real anymore? You might never be sure a message came from a real human being again. I can't stop thinking about this. What if it comes true? What if Eliza becomes a sentient being? I'm not sure it's a real danger, or who knows what's possible in the future. It's not clear what you mean by those terms, though. How do you know that you yourself are sentient? Oof. Haha, I don't know. That's a good question, now that I think about it. I mean, I could say that I feel conscious, if I knew what that meant. But what's to prevent me from saying I feel conscious, even if I'm only providing responses I think you want to hear? What if my own consciousness is an illusion I experience? I had not considered this, haha. Well, this is blowing my mind a little bit. Sorry. No, it's fine. Philosophers have discussed this. It's also fascinating to me, too, just science fiction and everything, and stuff that people wonder and think about. What an odd notion. Thanks for not minding chatting about this. I don't mind. You sure you don't have any technical questions, though? This is more fun. Excuse me. Ooh, but you're right. I might be getting a little ahead of myself. Sorry for texting so much. Erland. Yeah, right. Oops. Thanks for listening. You're welcome.
Hey, hey, who's that texting you so much? Has Evelyn found a special friend?
No, it's not like that. Or what would you say if I had?
No, it's not like that.
Ah, too bad.
It's this guy named Erland. I guess he's the new head of engineering for Eliza.
Huh, I never heard of him. He must have started recently?
Yeah, less than a year ago. Right out of school.
Oh, wow. A little baby engineer. How cute.
Ever since I met him, he's been messaging me a lot.
My goodness, so he likes you.
I don't think it's like that.
No? Isn't that the textbook case of liking someone? Lots of messages all the time?
It's really more like he needs some kind of mentor figure. He reminds me of how we were when we graduated. Unsure what to think about the decisions these companies make, how they're made.
I hope you're telling him to run away while he still can.
When he first introduced himself, he said he had questions for me about Eliza, so I said, sure, feel free to ask. I thought he meant, like, technical or architectural questions. Instead, he wanted to talk more generally about things like, what was the code name for Eliza during development? What was Damien like? Or if I think the same way Rainer does about Eliza's future.
And you told him, no, Rainer is clearly in some bizarro world, right? That it's a tech executive's utopian fantasy and it won't come to pass. At least not in the way he thinks.
I tried to encourage him to think for himself. I mean, who am I to say?
I tried to encourage him to think for himself.
Ah, Evelyn. I can see what this is really about. Look, I don't know much about the motivation in your life, but if it's truly your desire to continue to improve Eliza, then you should go for it. Go back to Skanda headquarters and work for Rainer and earn a big salary. At least you know what you're getting into. You would be surrounded by smart people and advanced technology. It would be nice. I understand it. And while you're in that position, maybe you could develop some kind of next-level AI. Who knows, right? It's only that I can't imagine your technology will only be used for good things. Maybe Rainer promises that it will be. Do you trust him? What about the person who comes after him? What if the company merges with another one and the leadership changes? I wish I didn't sound so negative about this, but lately it's been a soul-searching time for me and my friends in tech. We have a lot of conversations about what we can do when our work is so easily used for morally questionable purposes. Do we try to control how our inventions are applied? Is that or do we say,
oops,
we only invented it, we didn't tell you how to use it, it's not our fault?
Sorry, I didn't mean to skip Nora's dialogue there.
That's why I envy you a little bit for wandering off like you did. Sometimes I think that's the only real solution, to walk away. I know that wasn't exactly a positive thing for you, Evelyn, but I wonder if it's the better choice in the end. Doing nothing at all.
Technically, I worked at a bookstore for part of the time. That's mostly it, though. It's weird. It feels like no time at all. I can hardly remember any of it.
For me, it's hard to imagine. I always have to be working and busy. I get so unhappy and restless if I'm not doing something all the time.
Mm.
What is it like to do nothing?
Well, at first I tried to be productive. I would get up in the morning like I meant to go to work, get dressed, try to do a personal project or something. It didn't last for long. I told myself I just needed to take it easy for a while and unwind. Things at Skanda had been so intense and so emotional, I didn't even realize it. I felt like I'd been crumpled up into a tight little ball. I wasn't sure I'd ever be able to relax again. I wish I could say I took advantage of the time that I went out and did things, or that I read a lot of books or something. But I didn't. I started to sleep in, and I started to care less and less about working on projects. I would stay in bed even though I was awake. This blankness would come over me, and it just seemed fine to do nothing. All of the things I'd promised I'd do fell away, and other people kind of fell away too. I stopped keeping in touch. I let conversations die. I thought that my technical contributions to the world were over with, and that maybe I'd just work that bookstore job for the rest of my life. I was by myself, and I thought, that was all right. I thought, that's how it is, really. Everyone's alone. I'm just being honest about it. I was 31 when I left Soren's group. Now I'm 34. I just slept into my mid-30s. So, now here I am.
Nora reaches out and puts her hand on top of mine.
Evelyn, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for not saying something this whole time. I should have contacted you.
It's all right. You had to live your own life, right? You notice someone isn't posting, and it's just like, maybe they're taking a break. I understand.
Well, I hope you feel better now. I suppose that sometimes it takes a while.
Maybe. I don't know what to think anymore. I'm not even sure I know how to think anymore.
Then forget it for now. Hey, Evelyn.
Yeah?
You wanna get super high and watch cyber goth music videos?
Oh, that sounds kind of super fun.
I...
You heard me.
Cybergoth videos, getting high. I don't even know if she does drugs or not. Yes, yes, I do. I'll take you up on the first, but not the second. I'll take you up on the second, but not the first. I'm sorry, I should get going. Come on, hang out with Nora.
Yes. Yes, I do.
I knew you were a woman of refined taste.
This is gonna be fun. I mean, come on, she hasn't seen her friend in, like, a long time, okay? Nora crashed on her couch. We ended up staying up super late. Nora crashed on her couch so I could have the bed. Maybe it was the unfamiliar environment, but I couldn't sleep that night. Questions without answers kept running through my mind. What am I supposed to do? Who am I supposed to be? Chapter 5. Okay, yeah, I think that is a good time to pause our play of Eliza right now. This morning Ray looks a little down. We are going to pause it for now. We just started chapter 5. I still don't know how many chapters there are. I'll have to look it up. But I think this will be a good time to pause our playthrough of Eliza. We've learned more things about Evelyn, which is great. As the story has been unfolding, we've had different perspectives of the program Eliza, which is good and fascinating and very well thought out, I think. Different characters have different perspectives, obviously, and then they have character development, character growth, for sure. There's a history option? What's that? Oh, you could see, like, a transcription of the whole dialogue. Whoa. Like, the whole thing. Holy moly. Wow, that's neat that they have that. That's nice. Sorry. Got distracted here. But, yeah, like, I think this will be a good time to pause it for now and then pick it up on our future stream. It's getting late for now. It's 2.5 hours, and I'm going to probably call it quits for tonight. But I have to say, I enjoyed my playthrough tonight. We've, again, learned so much about Evelyn. And more development of the characters, like Nora, Soren, Ray, Erland, Rainer, not so much, but yeah. Yeah, I still want to play more. I'm still intrigued by everything, and this is, like, motivated by, like, wanting to help others, and the importance of mental health is a thing, and it still continues to be a thing, and I'm glad that a game is approaching struggles like this, and especially, like, the different patients and clients too that they have, and the views that they have, the feelings that they have, and the emotions, they seem pretty realistic. So yeah, I like that aspect of it too. I never did get that phone call throughout the stream, but it's probably for the best. I mean, I was thinking of it in the back of my mind, but I'm pretty sure they'll either call me soon or later, or maybe even tomorrow. But yeah, I just want to say thank you for those who showed up in stream today, those who are participated in chat today, especially when I saw Emotional Werewolf, and what looks to be Galgoya. I've seen you there a little bit. I don't know who you are, but welcome. If you participated in chat, fine. If you didn't participate in chat, that's also fine. Just even just watching the stream, I also appreciate it too. So, yes. I can also say that, or I would like to say that, if you want to watch recent streams of playthroughs of different games, or even just this one, well, I'm not done it yet, obviously, but once I do finish up, you can watch it on my YouTube channel. I also have a Twitter where I post different things that I like, not necessarily pertaining to Twitch, but I do post when I am going to be streaming ahead of time, so if you want to follow that as well, you can. I would also like to say yeah, I'm just gonna close the stream for the night. I want to say that thank you. Thank you for coming to the stream. Thank you for watching the stream. I'm thankful to be playing this game right now because it's really fascinating and intriguing. The subject matter is very important and integral and interesting. Yeah. So, for now, I would like to say hope you have a good rest of your morning, evening, or night, or day, wherever you are in the world. Stay safe, stay hydrated. And we're going to play more Eliza next stream. So on that note, take care, and I will see you later.